Hey friends, welcome to Chemistry Lover, and in this video I am going to discuss about elimination versus substitution reaction and what is the effect of solvent. Now the elimination versus substitution for a particular reaction condition is dependent on various factor, and solvent effect is one of the most important factor, and it has a very dramatic role. For example, you know from your 12th standard chemistry that treatment of ethanolic KOH with alkyl halide gives alkene, which is an elimination product, whereas when you treat the same alkyl halide with aqueous KOH, then you get alcohol, which is a substitution product. Now why is the difference? So we can see that just varying the solvent, keeping the nucleophile same and the starting material same, we can get two different outcomes. In one case it is elimination and in other case it is substitution. Now to find out why this is so, we have to look into the transition states of these two particular reactions, and that will give us the reason. So if we look at the transition state for substitution reaction, now we can consider this substitution reaction either as SN2 reaction or as SN1 reaction. Now in SN1 reaction it will go through a carbocation, whereas if it is in SN1 reaction it will go through a carbocation, whereas if the reaction is SN2, then it will go through this transition state. Now in the carbocation you can see this is a charged species which can be stabilized by a polar solvent like water, right? And also this transition state should also be stabilized by some polar solvent, okay? Because in the transition state you can see the negative charge is spread over these three atoms. Now let us look at the transition state for E2 elimination reaction, or generally we consider this reaction as E2 reaction because the substrate is perfect for E2 elimination reaction. And you know, if you use alkoxide or hydroxide, it will do E2 reaction because it is a strong base. So in E2 reaction you can see this is the transition state. Now if we compare the transition state for SN2 reaction and E2 reaction, you can see that in case of SN1 reaction the negative charge is spread over three atoms, right? Whereas in case of E2 reaction the negative charge is spread over five atoms. You can see this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now the overall negative charge is OH minus, right, which is a one unit negative charge. But in case of elimination reaction, this one unit negative charge is spread over five atoms, so the negative charge is largely diluted, whereas in case of substitution reaction it is spread over only three atoms, so it is more concentrated. So the charge density for the transition state of substitution reaction is much higher than that of elimination reaction. Now if you consider the two solvents, ethanol and or any alcohol and water, we can easily say that water is much polar than any alcohol solvent. Now more polar the solvent will be, more it will stabilize the charged intermediate or charged transition state, and we can see that the charge density is higher for your transition state for your substitution reaction. So that means water molecules will stabilize the transition state of this SN2 reaction or the carbocation in case of SN1 reaction much better than ethanol solvent. So that's why when you do the reaction in water solvent, the reaction largely go through this SN2 transition state and it will give you substitution product, whereas the ethanol molecules are good at stabilizing the less charge density transition state, and that's why it will stabilize the transition state for elimination reaction. And this is the reason when you do the reaction with alcoholic solvent you get the elimination product, that is alkene. So that's all. It is a very good example of solvent effect. So I hope you enjoy the video, and if you like this video then share this video with your friends, and also if you are new in this channel then you can subscribe my channel for getting more videos like that, and thank you for watching.